Living donors need to have a blood type that is compatible with the intended recipient. The positive or negative aspect of blood type does not matter in a crossmatch. The donor and recipient's blood are crossmatched to ensure the recipient does not react to the donor in a detrimental way. Since everyone's blood antibodies change over time, another crossmatch will be done just prior to surgery. Kidney recipients experience several benefits from receiving their transplant from a living donor. The surgery can be planned and scheduled to accommodate the schedules of the donor and the recipient. The recipient can receive a transplant sooner. It takes from 1 to 3 months to receive a kidney from a living donor. In Michigan, it takes an average of 5 years to receive a kidney from a deceased donor. Survival after transplant is generally better the sooner the transplant is performed. The transplants last longer. The average is 15 years from a living donor and 10 years from a deceased donor. Living donation increases the likelihood that a transplant will occur. Only about 50% of the patients put on the deceased donor waiting list ever receive a deceased donor transplant. Some patients die waiting or become too ill to survive the surgery. The risk of dying while on the waiting list is approximately 8% each year. Our paired kidney donation program offers new hope to patients who need a kidney transplant. Often, a patient who needs a kidney has a family member or a friend willing to donate one of his or her kidneys, but it cannot be done due to tissue or blood type incompatibilities. Paired donation seeks to match individuals who do not have a compatible donor or recipient with others in the same situation. If you and your intended recipient do not match by either blood type or cross-match, you may benefit from the paired donation program. Altruistic donors come forward with an offer to donate an organ, often without an intended recipient. Altruistic donors receive no financial or other incentives to donate. Their offers stem from a selfless regard for the welfare of another. One donation can begin a chain of organ matches in the paired donation program that may allow for many transplants to occur. For example, one kidney is donated and transplant 1 is matched and transplanted to recipient A. Recipient A had a donor who was not compatible, but now transplant 2 matches with and donates to recipient B. Recipient B had a donor who was not compatible, but now transplant 3 matches with and donates to recipient C. Recipient C had a donor who was not compatible, but now transplant 4 matches with and donates to recipient D. Recipient D had a donor who was not compatible, but now, and so on, and so on, and so on. The gift chain of donations continues as long as there are suitable donors and compatible recipients. Our first priority in assessing a person to become a living donor is their safety. The medical team and the donor advocate will focus on the donor's needs to promote their best interests. It is important to understand that donors can be ruled out at any point in the process if the team feels you cannot proceed safely to donation. The risk to a donor is low, with death occurring in about 1 in 3,000 donations. Complications that would require further medical care occur in approximately 1 in 15 donations, such as wound or bladder infections. Potential donors who have well-controlled hypertension, also known as high blood pressure, may be acceptable as donors if they meet certain criteria. The hypertension must be well-controlled with one medication. The donor must be over 50 years of age, and they must successfully complete an expanded workup. In addition, they must sign an informed consent agreeing to a schedule for follow-up care in the first year and beyond as part of a clinical study on hypertensive donors. The expanded donor workup includes the standard testing plus an echocardiogram, a test to measure exact kidney function through a blood test, an eye exam, and a 24-hour ambulatory blood pressure monitor. Metabolic syndrome is a name for the group of high-risk factors that occur together and increase the risk for type 2 diabetes, coronary artery disease, and stroke. Donors may be required to complete a metabolic workup depending upon their weight and their family history. The metabolic workup may include a waist circumference measurement, a lipid profile through a blood test, and a 2-hour glucose tolerance test. Additionally, a 24-hour ambulatory blood pressure monitor may be ordered. Any potential donor with a body mass index, or BMI, greater than 40 or diagnosed with metabolic syndrome will not qualify as a suitable donor.